don't want to
support.
No, I want to speak about the manuscripts.
No, I know.
Your manuscripts.
No, I know.
Yeah, we want to speak about the manuscripts as well, but we want to question why Qur'anic Jesus is much, much powerful than Allah.
Why is
this woman a hyena? Allah is a hyena.
We're not here to attack you.
And we all know what Islam teaches about hyenas. So, I am asking the simple question, and Muslims are not answering again. Again? Not again, man. Very simple question. I want Muslim to answer. Why Islamic Jesus destroys Allah, yet Islamic dawah him just run away?
Okay, that's a question.
Why does Jesus create faster than Allah?
Ah, okay.
You want to ask Shamsi, but he doesn't want to answer.
Oh.
Why? I guess he doesn't know the answer.
Shams.
Which is shame, actually.
He knows the answer.
I have a question.
I just want to know.
Okay, so my question is, why Islamic Jesus in the Quran much, much better than as a creator Allah? Why he is much faster than Allah? Why Islamic Jesus in the Quran destroys Allah? I've got three simple questions. Are you able to answer?
Wait, what is it?
No, but do you have the answer, or are you just going to say don't talk about it?
Instead of you just rejecting the Shaitan, right?
You don't have answers. You guys are scared.
So I have a simple question. While Muslims are doing in-house debates, should they answer my question or not? My question still stands. Islamic dawah him.
Yes.
You turn up the corner week after week. Attack my God. Yet failed once again to just answer simple question. Why Islamic Jesus is destroying Allah?
Bible says so.
Where does it say?
Did you get baptized? Did you get baptized? No, you didn't.
Does it say?
Do you have an answer to my question?
Is in the church only?
Okay, so.
Show me where she's shaving. Don't divert. Show me where she's
shaving. So I'm just going to make my point. So I am asking a very simple question. Even though Islam teaches tahweed, still we see Islamic Jesus is much, much, much better and much higher than and much quicker creator than Allah. Allah gives one of his attributes to Jesus, and Jesus does much better work than Allah. So, Surah 3 verse 49 and Surah 5 verse 110 tells us Jesus creates a bird out of clay with his powerful breath. Jesus gives life to bird. So, it is exactly the same way Allah creates Adam. Allah creates Adam out of clay, and Allah breathes into Adam, and then it takes on Friday moon time tonight for Allah to finish Adam. And Allah doesn't finish Adam. Adam says, finish me before it is night. So, can you just tell me why Jesus creates exactly the way Allah does, and he's much, much quicker and faster creator?
Who gave him the power to create in the first place?
Jesus had the power. It's not about who gave him the power. If it is Allah, or if it is the Qudsar Ruh Qudus, who gave him the power, why would Allah in the first place give power to creature to create exactly the same way Allah does? So, Surah 3 verse 49, the verses I am asking the question, and Surah 5 verse 110, the passages I am looking. Can you please tell me, why do you worship a slow creator? Can you just tell me? He's very, very slow, and it is at night. Allah hasn't finished yet.
The answer is that Prophet Isa wouldn't be able to create it in the first place unless Allah allowed him. And that was just a miracle which Allah gave him. And even in the Quran it says, and I'm sorry, I don't know the exact reference, yeah, but it says that Isa was only a messenger of Allah, and any miracles that he did, he only done through us. So even if he did create a bird, really,
by the permission of Allah,
he only did it through the creation of Allah.
Bible says so.
Let me respond to that. Here's the Quran for you. First, bring your reference and we examine your reference. And I'm going to bring you my reference and I want to explain that, okay? I'll give you the Quran.
I don't know.
Check the Google and then give me the reference. I'm not going to continue to with you unless Bible. You give me the reference from your holy book what you are saying.
Jesus has been, Peter said to the Jew, a man among you who did wonder and miracle on...
Sir, do you have an answer to my question?
Yes, so I just told you that in the Quran it says that he created, that Isa was only a messenger of Allah, and any powers that he had was only done through Allah.
Okay, so I am waiting for the reference for you to produce from the Quran, Isa is only messenger and he created only with the power Allah gave it to him.
But also, can I ask you a question?
First, yes, you will ask me question after you answer my questions.
But still a question that you have to answer.
Yeah, first answer my question and I'm going to respond to your question. I am here every week. I never run away. If I don't know, I go home, do my homework. So give me the reference and then we move on from that.
Surah 5 verse 75
supposed to be the reference I am looking. Jesus is only the messenger of Allah and Allah give him power to do things. The Messiah, son of Mary, was not but a messenger. Messenger have passed on before him. And his mother was supporter of Taurat. They both eat food. Look how we make it, we make clear to them the signs. Then we look how they are deleted. That doesn't answer my question. My question was asking very simple reference. Where is in the Quran? You made a claim. Where is it in the Quran? Allah says, Jesus is the messenger of Allah. Allah give him power so that Jesus can do the things. That doesn't tell me. So I'll give you couple of more minutes. Give me the reference.
Okay. I'll come to you next week because I have to do my own research.
So you needed to come to me last time again when we talked about how Jesus is identified the Son of God. You didn't come back to me. It looks like you have a very busy homework schedule that you are not responding. So if you are telling me that you don't have the reference, from now on I am thinking Jesus had a power to create exactly the way Allah does, and he's much, much, much better creator, since you don't have the reference for that. So, can you tell me, while Jesus is not first and better creator, why do you still follow Allah?
Can I answer my question? Ask my question. So, you've made a claim that Jesus had his own power, but since you're the accusing party, you now have the burden of proof to produce evidence where Prophet Isa did miracles on his own accord and not through Allah.
Yeah. That's a good question. Let me back it up what I said. Surah 4. I have lots of problem with Islamic Jesus. I think Islamic Jesus is taking you to hell as well, but I want you to just make a point. There is some disturbing teachings in the Quran about Islamic Jesus. Here's the chapter 5, verse 110. When Allah will say, O Jesus, son of Mary, remember my favor upon you and your mother, when I supported you, strengthened you with the pure spirit.
Wait, sorry, can you say that again? I didn't hear the... It's a bit loud. Just to...
Just don't you have Quran with you, sir? You can check it out. Surah 5, verse 110. I read it again from the beginning, but it's helpful for you to follow up what I'm reading. When Allah will say, "Oh Jesus, son of Mary, remember my favor upon you and upon your mother when I strengthened you with Ruhu Kudus. When you spoke to the people in the cradle and in maturity, and when I taught you writing and wisdom, and the Torah and the Gospel, and when you designed from a clay, like a form of a bird, with my permission, then you breathed into it, and it became a bird with my permission." Okay? "And you healed the blind and the leper with my permission. And when you brought forth the dead with my permission, when I restrained the children of Israel from you, when you came to them with clear proofs that those who disbelieve among them said, this is not but obvious magic." So let me just tell you what the verse is, because it was long verse. According to Surah 5, verse 110, Jesus, okay, he speaks in the cradle. Jesus is the one who, with the permission of Allah, Jesus is the one from the clay makes a bird, breathes into bird, and bird becomes alive. With the permission of God, Jesus is the one who heals the leper. Jesus is the one who heals the sick. Jesus is the one who gives life to dead, according to Surah 5, verse 110. Yes. Can you tell me why Allah giving this power to Jesus, why Jesus has this power to heal the sick, make a life out of the clay with his own breath?
Okay, so it's fine. I don't have to bring you the reference, because the reference is right here. And the key words here, it says, when you design from clay, like the form of a bird, with my permission, which implies that without his permission, he would not be able to do it. So even though it was Prophet Isa that created the bird, it was only because Allah allowed him to. But, and also to answer your question, usually the people that he preached to, and I'm sure even you would agree, like the disbelievers in the Bible, when like Prophet Isa or Jesus used to preach to them, they never used to believe him. So Allah gave him miracles to prove that he must have come from God, and he even says, "Through my permission."
Okay?
Yeah.
So, thank you once again. You just confirmed for me I will never become a Muslim, and you just confirmed for everyone Islam is false religion, Muhammad is false prophet, and Quran is false book. You said Allah needed to use Jesus to make a miracle so that people can believe Jesus is prophet, while Muhammad failed to do even one miracles. Yet he's turned out around and I said, "Guys, by the way, I am a prophet." That just proves for me Islam is false religion. Can you just explain it to me? You did not answer my question. I'm not dealing with the Allah give permission or not. I am asking the simple question. Why does Jesus have this power? Jesus is walking around, not with the power that he can give life, but his breath can give life, okay? Jesus has the power. Allah is the only one who gives permission. While Allah gives permission, Allah commits shirk. This cameraman, he has power to punch me, but he doesn't have permission to do that. Power and permission are two different things. I am asking the simple question, why at the first place, this, according to your so-called Prophet Isa, has this power?
Yeah, I just answered your question.
No, you didn't.
I did, because people never used to believe that he was a prophet of Allah. So Allah gave him he basically gave him the permission to basically perform these miracles. And I think perhaps you're looking in it a bit too deeply. When he said permission, it basically implies that he could only do it through the power of Allah. And even though you're trying to basically make a false dichotomy where you're basically trying to say that permission and power are basically different things, it's not really. I think maybe it's just a misunderstanding, and that's not really your fault. But when he's saying permission, he's implying that he never had any power by himself. It was basically through Allah that he was able to do that. And also to respond to your other point, where you said that the Prophet Muhammad could not perform any miracles. It says here in Surah Najm, Surah Qamar, chapter 54, verse 1. The hour has come near, and the moon has split too. And if they see a miracle, they turn away, passing magic. So here it shows that the Prophet Muhammad did perform miracles, and there are many, many other miracles that he performed, which you can see in Bukhari and Muslim, such as once when there was only a little bit of milk and many people could drink from it, and many others. I don't want to name them all, but yeah, you're basically claiming that the Prophet Muhammad couldn't perform any miracles, but he could.
Okay. So you made 2 points. One of them were simply power and permission are the same thing. I want you to back it up from the Quran. I really fed up when Muslims just comes with the nice movie scenarios and then brings up the verses. Quran doesn't say that. So you need to tell me, you need to provide from the Quran, permission and power are the same. They are two different things. You have a power as a man to punch me. He has a power to punch me, but he doesn't have permission because he's Christian. His scripture doesn't give that. My question is to you, why at the first place Jesus has that power, the power which he can give life with his breath? Why Jesus is walking around with the powerful breath that he can give a life? Unless you bring a Quran, you bring a something for me which tells you power and the permission are same, I will have to disagree with you until then. If you bring that, then that's fine, we can settle that down. Second point. I don't want you to come up with speaker's corner and then say, like I said, this is your holy book where you get your authority. Bring the things from well-detailed, well-explained word of Allah. Allah should know what is the difference between power and permission. There are even two different Arabic words. How come Allah fails Arabic here? Surah 54, verse 1. That just for me proves again, Islam is false religion, Muhammad is false prophet, and Quran is false book. Verse states, the hour has come near and the moon has split. So there are two interpretations for that. Well detailed and well explained. Quran doesn't explain it well. Here's the one of the interpretation. It's going to take place at the last day. Other interpretation is, yes, lovely Muhammad did, because you've got the hadith supports that. What did you study at school, sir?
What, in college?
Or university?
English, history, and philosophy.
So you studied English, philosophy, history, and ethics. Can you just tell me very simply, this is general knowledge, what happens, what is the job of the moon? What does moon do? Why there is at the first place moon? If moon is not there, what is the consequences of that?
I think it's the waves. The waves, there won't be any waves in the ocean. You might, I'm not good at science. I took
that's a general question, though. No? Yeah, anyway, I'm, you failed on that. I run science class, you should come time to that.
Yeah,
here's the thing. Without moon, we wouldn't have our living conditions we have today. If in 7th century, according to hadith, as hadith makes a claim, moon is split into half, one went to the east, other one went to the west, climate wouldn't be exactly the same. Everyone would be talking about water will be increased, old, everything is messed up. But there is nothing tells us that happened. So you need to back it up for me, and you need to prove that verse with the other verses, which says prophets before me did the miracles. You did not believe that. Therefore, I won't be doing any miracles. So I'll give you the reference for that. I'll check the reference for that, and then I'll give you time to respond to me regarding where, regarding the power and permission. Okay. So I'm just gonna give me 1 minute.
Pause. Actually, water time.
Yeah, hey, Hatun, do you want to go in the shade? Because it's up to you.
Wait.
So.
I don't know this.
Oh, sorry.
Do you want to go in the shade?
No, I'm fine.
Well, oh yeah, you're Turkish, so you're probably used to it.
Action.
So let's see what does Quran say about if your prophet did a miracle, which you acknowledged, prophet needed to be believed your prophet, you needed to do miracle, that because of that Allah give power to Jesus to make a miracle, which you need to back it up. But let me read what the Quran says. Surah 29 verse 50 and 51. But they say, Why are not signs sent down to him from his Lord? Say, the signs are only with Allah, and I am only a clear warner. It is not sufficient for them that we have sent down to you a book, which is recite to them. Oh Muhammad, we can't believe you are prophet. Where are your signs and miracles? Muhammad turns to them. Oh, it is with Allah. No signs and miracles. Surah 6, verse 109. People swear that they would believe if they saw the signs. But Muhammad replied, and they swear by Allah, their strongest oath, that if a sign come to them, they would surely believe in it. Say, the signs are only with Allah. And what will make you perceive that even if a sign come, they would not believe? Surah 17, verse 93. Or you have a house of gold, or sand ascend into sky, and even then, we will not believe in your ascension until you bring down to us a book we may read. Say, exalted is my Lord, was I ever but a human messenger? Surah 18 verse 110. I am only a man like you, to whom has been revealed that your God is one. So whoever would hope for the meeting with his Lord, let him do righteous work and not associate worship of his Lord anymore. Four verses. All of their background, Muhammad is questioned to produce a sign, make a miracle. What Muhammad does, I can't do any miracle. Miracle is only with Allah. Why do you go against your own scripture and then tell me Muhammad did miracles?
Okay, so of course I could be petty and just say that signs and miracles aren't the same thing. But one thing that you keep missing is that it says that the Quran is a miracle. So the Quran itself was a miracle and a sign to the people.
Are you going to respond to the power and permission?
Are you going to respond to the signs and miracles?
Yeah. Okay, so you pass it to me? Okay. I just wanted to make sure you're speaking up. So, Quran is a miracle. So as I am Christian, okay, I believe I have a God who steps in time and places, and he does make miracles. Jesus, truly God-man, walked on the water. He did the miracles only God himself do. I don't have any problem with miracles. But Islam does have a problem with miracles. Islam tells us Muhammad can't do any miracles. Muhammad can't do any miracles because all of them are with Allah. Muhammad fails to produce us a miracle. Quran is a miracle. No, there is nothing in the Quran. Corrupted book, changed and transformed by human beings. Even a goat came and ate it. How can Quran be a miracle? How can corrupted word of Allah, according to Islamic tradition, can be miracle? Quran doesn't even understand history. Quran comes and destroys science. Quran comes and take away dignity and value of human beings. So you need to bring me reference, bring me your sources that Quran is miracle. But before that, I don't want you to just get out from the conversation. I am asking you the simple question: why Jesus has a power to give life, and create exactly the way Allah does, and Jesus is much, much quicker than Allah? That's my only question. I'm not gonna deal with the science thing. Just first deal with my questions and then we move on.
Okay, I don't wanna divert too much because then we'd be getting into history and so on. But I'll just give a quick example of a miracle and how the Quran is a miracle. For example, like, you know the word Pharaoh? In the ancient Egyptian kingdom, the word was para, and according to the Encyclopedia Britannica, used to refer to like the kingdom of Pharaoh, right? But then in later times, and around Moses' time, it referred to the ruler, like a Pharaoh ruler, basically. And the Quran, even though it was from a prophet or a man who just lived in the desert, who had no access to the hieroglyphics or any technology, the Quran was able to distinguish this. For example, when it was referring to Joseph, who was in the time of the ancient kingdom, in Surah 12, Surah Yusuf, verse 56, it uses the word king instead of the word pharaoh. But then later on, when it's talking about Moses, it uses the correct term. It uses the word pharaoh, which is the correct term. But even the Bible couldn't do so, whereby if you look in Genesis 41, when it talks about Joseph, who was in the ancient times, and the word Pharaoh meant just a kingdom and not a king, it uses the word Pharaoh. So I don't want to like divert too much because I want to stay on task, but that was just a quick example of how the Quran is a miracle, has scientific miracles and so on. So the Quran itself is considered as a miracle.
Are you going to respond? Because that is your conclusion. Are you going to respond to my one and essential question, power and permission thing? Why Allah is giving power to Jesus? Permission.
Yeah, but see, I think you're looking into it a bit too much. And I could do the same for you because all the references that you listed when you're talking about how the Prophet Muhammad never had any miracles, the word used was signs, not miracles. But of course, we know that if we don't look into it too deeply into the language, we know that it's referring to miracles. So I could equally be just as petty with you as you could with me. So when it's talking about he did it through the permission of Allah, he's basically referring to the fact that he could not do anything himself. Yeah, it was only through Allah who allowed him to do it. And it was him that gave him the power to do it.
So, I came to you with the simple question, why Jesus has power to create exactly the way Allah does, yet and gives life with his breath exactly the way Allah does, yet Jesus is much quicker and faster than Allah. And you have not responded to my question. Are you aware of it? Permission and power are very different things. You know, as a Muslim, you know much better than me, there is something called shirk. And one group of the shirk is when you give name and attributes of Allah to something else. Allah is a creator, yet Allah gives his attributes and his power to someone called Jesus. Allah is committing shirk, and Muslims are just following that man who commits the shirk, or Allah commits the shirk. There is something wrong on that. Since we established that you failed to respond to my question, let me just deal with your claim that Muhammad makes a miracle, that miracle is the Quran.
May I answer your question?
We are about to finish. I'm going to come to you.
May I answer?
I'm about to finish.
He's not able to answer.
I'm about to finish, so this is the conclusion part. I'll come to you. Sir, are you listening?
Oh, sorry.
So your second point was, Quran is by itself as a miracle. And your reference for that, for Surah 12, that Quran got the title, if that is your reason, by itself, just a miracle, I am sorry, but you have to apply to Oxford Dictionary people and then tell them to change the definition of the miracle. That's not at all miracle. Miracle Quran destroys history, destroys science. That's not enough. That miracle Quran was eaten by an animal. That's not miracle at all. And it is not acceptable. So that was your conclusion. This is my conclusion. Let me say one more sentence. One more thing. You come to speaker's corner, you've got to learn your own Quran to defend it before you attack my faith. So far, your Quran is not going to give you the eternal life. So far, your Quran is not going to take you to God. It is only Lord Jesus Christ, who is crucified on the cross for your sins, which is a failed knowledge of Allah, that Lord Jesus Christ is offering eternal life, and you must repent and come to him, sir.
Can I respond?
That was your conclusion statement. I did my conclusion statement.
I didn't know that was a conclusion.
Oh, wait.
Okay, do your conclusion.
Okay, so you're talking about what's the difference between
your second conclusion.
Sorry. I didn't know that.
That's fine. That's fine.
That's fine.
That's fine.
So you're talking about, well, about the difference between a miracle. What was it? Sorry, a miracle and a miracle
power.
And a sign. What was it? The two
so
words.
You, yeah.
Permission and power.
Permission, yeah.
But you also couldn't differentiate between miracle and sign. So I could be equally as petty with you as you could with me. And I'll admit, I don't know about the history about the crucifixion of Jesus, and I'll have to look into it, and it'll probably take some time. I'll put my hands up and admit that. Then thirdly, you were talking about how it's created between the backbone and the rib. And even though I don't have any scientific evidence, I'll put my hands up and say again, what it's referring to is about how it's basically a place between the kidney, and that place was basically the source of
the backbone.
Yeah, no, it's between the backbone and the rib.
Rib.
Yeah, and the 11th and 12th rib. And I'll admit that I don't know like any evidence to support it, but that's what it's referring to.
Yeah.
And
so you don't have any evidence to support it, but you know that's what it's referred to.
No, I haven't looked into it deeply enough.
So here,
and fourthly, sorry, you haven't responded about the difference between the pharaoh and like how it used to be kingdom, and how it used to be the ruler, and how the Bible got it wrong in Genesis 41, whereas the Quran was able to differentiate between the two, which is a sign of it being a miracle of Prophet Muhammad. But that's my conclusion. We can look into.
So I have a right. Can I respond to your conclusion, or it's done?
Because I made a mistake. So.
Okay. So, thank you for telling me. Even though in the Quran Allah says, historical fact of Jesus as crucifixion, that you don't know enough and you will go and do your homework. I am amazed. That's a good thing, because you will come to the conclusion that Allah fails with that. You will come to that conclusion. I have not responded to your claims regarding the Pharaoh and the king. Reason for that was because that doesn't make Quran a miracle. Quran, it's already a miracle by eating a goat. That makes it a miracle. I have not, so, and you already said you don't have enough knowledge of the science to talk about where the baby comes from.
No, I'm talking about the backbone.
Where the semen, that's where the semen comes from. So, sir, do you speak English? You ask for no, but you don't speak English. That's why. Okay. Okay, JC, focus. JC, focus. You are man, JC.
Abbas.
So I need a man knowledge here. I am female. I don't know those basics. Okay? Tell me, Abbas, where the semen comes from?
The genitals.
Okay? Let's look at. Did you hear that? Okay? I'm not going to verbalize what he said, but people already heard it.
I could be wrong, but that's what I think.
I am sure as even the 11 years old child knows where the semen comes from. So it has. So I'm doing my conclusion. The claims you made about miracle of the Quran just proves once again Islam is false religion, Quran is false book, Muhammad is false book. And those three things seriously affects your eternity, because Allah doesn't know where the semen comes from, Allah doesn't know the crucifixion, even JC knows, and he's laughing at it. He's laughing at your Allah. I will laugh it when I get home. Anyways, on the serious side of it, Quran is not a miracle at all. Not at all. It wasn't miracle in 7th century. It is not miracle in 21st century. And this non-miracle book is gonna take you to hell unless you acknowledge Lord Jesus Christ died on the cross for your sins. With out of grace, God gave his only son so that you can be redeemed. Yet today, you still call Quran a miracle. Miracle is the death and resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ, sir. Okay. You've got to come to that one.
Should we basically look into it and we can discuss it, like the scientific part? No, you know the scientific part, and you know about the pharaoh.
Yeah.
Yeah, we can. But okay. It was a good discussion.
But before that, before you pass those things, I need you to produce references for me for the claims you make. You can't come to the corner and then you say, oh, when Allah says permission, actually Allah meant power. Because that's already discredits your God, and you wouldn't want to be in a place that you know much better than Allah. No one wants to be in that place, okay? So back up your claims, and then we move to the science, and then we move to the Old Testament reference as well.
Also look for a reference where it says that a sign and a miracle are the same thing.
Sure.
I was a bit confused.
The overall point